Major Reber, do you solemnly swear the testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do, sir.
You may be seated. Mr. Jenkins, you may take over the inquiry.
Will you please tell this... As a result of that request, did you go to his office?
Yes, sir, I did, on the afternoon of Wednesday, July 8th.
And was anyone present when you arrived at his office besides Senator McCarthy?
My first conversation was with the senator alone in his office, sir.
I will ask you at this time, General, to relate to this committee the conversation verbatim as well as you can remember it.
At that time, Senator McCarthy informed me that he was very much interested in obtaining a direct reserve commission for his consultant, Mr. G. David Shine.
Did you know G. David Shine at that time?
I did not know him personally.
Had you heard of him?
Yes, sir, I had.
Proceed with the conversation.
The senator pointed out, as I recall it, that he felt that Mr. Shine, because of his background of investigative experience with the committee, was fully qualified for a commission.
What else, if anything, did Senator McCarthy state to you on that occasion?
At about that time, as I recall it, a few minutes after I initiated my conversation with the senator, Mr. Roy Cohn came into the room. Mr. Cohn also emphasized...
Was Mr. Cohn chief counsel for Senator McCarthy and his committee at that time? That is, for Senator McCarthy?
Yes, sir, he was.
All right, you may proceed.
Mr. Cohn came into the room. He further emphasized the qualifications of Mr. Shine for a commission.
Will you state what qualifications Mr. Cohn claimed to have been possessed by Mr. Shine at that time?
Mr. Cohn informed me that Mr. Shine had been a junior ship's officer. Stated, in effect, that he desired to come over to the Pentagon that afternoon and hold up his hand.
Hearsay evidence, I think that obviously the chair must be leaning to a certain extent in allowing hearsay. And the other, I know that you don't follow the court rules. On the other hand, if evidence of any importance is put in by way of hearsay, I believe the individual who was quoted should be available so he can be put under oath and be sworn. And I make that point because the general now is repeating hearsay.
As the chair replies, screening
chairman, and if they are not produced as witnesses, I certainly will not insist upon hearsay testimony.
Very good, sir. You may proceed.
Now, General, will you proceed with your statement?
After receiving of July, I received numerous telephone calls from Mr. Cohn. Either one or no telephone calls, but I received consistently throughout that period, possibly an average